Welcome to this video on triangles. In the previous video, we discussed about the angle side angle ASA criterion for the congruence of triangles. Today we will solve some questions related to that. Come, let's start. The first question is, in quadrilateral ABCD, diagonal AC is the bisector of angle BAD and angle BCD. Show that triangle DAC is congruent to triangle BAC. We are given that diagonal AC is the bisector of angle BAD. Therefore, we can say that angle DAC and angle BAC will be equal. Diagonal AC is also the bisector of angle BCD, that is, angle DCA will be equal to angle BCA. Now, look at triangle DAC and triangle BAC. Here, these two angles are equal to each other, and side AC is the common side. Notice that this side is the interior side of the two angles. From equations 1, 2 and 3, we can say that these two triangles are congruent as per ASA or the angle side angle congruence rule for triangles. Let's move ahead to our next question. In the figure, if point O is the midpoint of the line segment PQ and angle OQN is equal to angle OPM, then show that triangle OQN is congruent to triangle OPM and tell the relationship between sides MO and NO. Here we are given that point O is the midpoint of line PQ. Therefore, QO will be equal to PO. Now, look at triangle OQN and triangle OPM. We are given that these two angles are equal. Look at the figure carefully. The two angles are vertically opposite angles, that is, angle NOQ and angle MOP will be equal. In these two triangles, two angles and their included side are equal. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent as per the ASA congruence rule for triangles. Friends, we know that corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal to each other. Therefore, side MO is equal to side NO. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we solved some questions related to the angle side angle ASA congruence rule for triangles. See you in the next video. Thank you.